Hey, hello there. I'm Scott Rogers, Technical Marketing Manager for Tanzu Observability by Wavefront. And today we're going to look at the art of the possible and how you can use Tanzu Observability to observe your Tanzu application platform, in this case, running on Amazon's Elastic Kubernetes Service. This is the Tanzu Observability integrations page. Here you'll find over 250 integrations to make it easy for you to bring your telemetry data into the Tanzu Observability platform. Okay, this is a Tanzu Observability dashboard that I've created to help give me insight into my TAP stack and to the workloads running on top. Here you can see we have visibility into the EC2 instances underlying EKS, to the Kubernetes services running on EKS, two different components within TAP, such as Knative and Tekton, and finally, all the way to the workload itself, in this case, instrumented with OpenTelemetry. Let's look at each of these layers and see how we did it. AWS and Kubernetes are both native integrations for Tanzu Observability. Let's navigate to the integrations page and show what that looks like. The integrations page gives you instructions for how to add an integration. Really, it's just giving read-only access to the account to pull back these metrics. Once data starts flowing, you'll have availability of all of these dashboards. And you can think of all of these as jumping off points for how to start creating your own visualizations. The same is true for the Kubernetes integration. Setup for Kubernetes is quite simple. It's really just running choosing which broad flavor of Kubernetes you want to install for, and then running a couple of commands, a kubectl to create a namespace and a helm install to install the Wavefront collectors and proxy. Once you do that, you start getting all this great information that helps you understand the Kubernetes in your environment. For example, this is the default Kubernetes summary. In this particular environment I'm looking at, we have a couple of clusters reporting into it. All right, let's go back to our TAP full stack view, and let's look at the EC2 layer. So in this case, I'm bringing back EC2 metrics around CPU and network. These are two metrics I think might be meaningful when I'm starting troubleshooting problems or performance issues to see if there's any bottlenecks there. Before I go much further into our dashboards, I'd like to point out that all of the visualizations you see are built using the Wavefront query language. Here we see we're using the AWS EC2 CPU utilization average metric as a time series, and we're visualizing that along with some filters and then doing some interpolation to fill in some gaps based upon the time frame where we pull back, from which we pull back data. I'd like to point out how easy it is, though, to start getting information, to start visualizing information using this platform. Perhaps you don't want to take the time to get intimate with the Wavefront query language. Well, that's fine. You can simply use the query builder and start building visualizations that are meaningful to you immediately. So here we see that I've already pulled back information on CPU utilization from AWS. And by the way, what's really cool here is that you can, in addition to being able to use a query builder, you can also use PromQL. So we found some customers have an investment in PromQL. If that's the case, you can ingest your metrics the same way and use PromQL rather than Wavefront query language to start building these visualizations. All of these are just ways to make it easy for people to get value quickly and start visualizing this information. So again, the AWS integration is coming from a native integration, AWS information coming from a native integration. And the next layer is Kubernetes. You saw that that's installed using the Helm chart. You saw we have a lot of things we can bring back. The idea here is to visualize performance issue. And now we can start seeing things vertically in our stack, right? We can, if we had a performance issue, we might be able to correlate this CPU utilization, that CPU utilization, and start understanding what's happening in our environment. That's kind of the idea with this, right? The next layer is where some of the magic happens with some native functionality available to you from our Kubernetes collector. So our Kubernetes integration installs a collector for each node, and also installs a proxy. Well, the cool thing that happens here is that our collector will scrape Prometheus endpoints and bring that information back with no additional effort on your part, other than ensuring that the pod has the right annotation. So here's an example where I annotated the Tekton pipelines controller with Prometheus IO scrape equals true, and then Prometheus IO port equals 9090. All this does is let our collector know where to find those Prometheus metrics and start bringing the information back. When you do that, you start getting Tekton metrics available to use. And here I've built a visualization that counts the number of pipeline runs in the past 24 hours. It's pretty cool I can do that. I'm really using the metric that comes back. It's a counter metric, Tekton pipelines controller counter. You can see I've had 39 runs since inception in this particular case. Using some of the magic of Wavefront query language, I'm able to do some math on it and figure out I've had two in the past 24 hours. I think that's great because what that starts doing is giving your platform operators insight into what's going on with builds and releases and pipeline activities so they can start troubleshooting should things go sideways. In addition to Tekton, we've instrumented the Knative eventing our services as well. In this case, I've overlaid Knative requests versus reconciles. And I like to think of reconciles as kind of like cold starts, right? So in this context, I'm seeing how many requests I'm serving versus how many cold starts are happening. I think that can be really useful in understanding performance of a platform. Here I've summed up all the Knative requests coming in. And here, just to show different types of information we get back, this is a histogram showing latency for those same Knative requests, right? So these are ways to visualize information that you get through the native functionality available to you in the Tanzu Observability Kubernetes Collector. Let's go on to the workload. In this case, I'm running an instance of Pet Clinic. And you can see here, I'm looking at AppDex of Pet Clinic. AppDex is an industry standard measure that just says that measures customer satisfaction based upon response time. And it's a function that's available, it's a native function available to you in our analytics functions to calculate that number for you. Here I'm measuring requests per second, top failed request, top number of request count, and slowest request. These are kind of the red metrics, the request errors and latency. And here I'm just kind of visualizing the request rate of the different types of requests in a line chart. All of this is to illustrate I'm getting all this great metrics from my workloads using the OpenTelemetry operator for Kubernetes and doing auto injection for this Java application. Didn't have to touch the code or anything else. I think that's pretty cool. So in addition to the metrics, we're also getting traces the same way. This is our traces browser, and as it loads, there we go, we can see the traces and spans inside those traces during that time frame. Again, getting all of this using the OpenTelemetry auto injection. Let's jump back over to our TAP full stack dashboard. Let's give a quick recap of what we've seen here today. So what we've done, we've built a visualization that helps us understand the health of our TAP stack all the way from the EC2 instances underlying EKS through the Kubernetes layer running on top of EKS, and then using some of the native functionality available to you in our Wavefront collector for Kubernetes, I'm able to bring back Prometheus endpoints and start making visualizations of things happening with inside of TAP, in this case Knative and the Knative and Tekton layers. And then we've instrumented a workload, in this case bring Pet Clinic, running on top of Kubernetes. Wow, we just covered a lot of information in a very short period of time. If you'd like to try any of these things for yourself, simply use this QR code to navigate to this website to get your 30-day free trial. Once again, I'm Scott Rogers, Technical Marketing Manager for Tanzu Observability by Wavefront, and I hope you've enjoyed this video. Thank you.